and welcome to Skitty Animates. I'm Skitty, and today I'm going to teach you all about Tween Machine. If you're unfamiliar with what Tween Machine is, it's a very useful tool to help you create eases and overshoots using math. Before you get intimidated and click off the video, just hear me out. This can save you a lot of time, and there's not much math involved. I'll leave a link in the description so that you can download Tween Machine yourself. There is instructions on the website as to how to install it into Maya, so I'm not gonna cover that in this video. I've created a button for Tween Machine on my shelf here, and this is the whole program right here. Now, if I select all of the controls on my character, I have a couple poses from a previous tutorial. We have the starting pose, the in-between, and the ending pose. So if we click play, it doesn't look very good. It's just three poses, evenly timed, going in and out of each other. So what Tween Machine will help you with is easing into the next pose, overshooting into the next pose, and maybe holding a pose for a little bit longer before transitioning. So let's start with the first two poses, the beginning and the breakdown. Use your own discretion whether you want to do an ease or an overshoot based on the animation that you're doing. I'm going to do an ease for the first pose, just as an example, and an overshoot for the second pose, again, just for an example. So if we go in between these two poses and click on Tween Machine, we have a slider, a number over here, and some bars at the bottom. Basically, these bars at the bottom represent each segment towards the next pose to create a pose within the other two poses. All the way back at negative 100 is your first pose, and all the way to positive 100 is your second pose. Typically, we're not going to use Tween Machine for that because we can always just drag and drop our poses. We want the first pose to last longer than the breakdown. Then on frame 3, we're going to set the value, let's say at negative 80. So what this did was it made frame 3 80% towards frame 1 and 20% towards frame 6. You can see it's slower here, and then it gets faster. We could make that even slower. We could make that 92%, 92.4. Now there's barely any movement here, and all the movement is after the Tween Machine pose. This is extremely useful for moving holds because you don't want a character to stand dead still for longer than 20 frames at a time. And even still, unless you're doing very snappy, poppy animation, you want there to be at least a pixel of movement. So if we took these poses and just shot them way over down the timeline, you can see that from frame 1 to frame 13, it still looks real because there's a slight hold. We'll undo that. What I'm actually going to set this on is probably somewhere around 75. I'm going to set a frame at the end just to hold it there so we can work in the middle. Now what I'm going to show you is an overshoot. Now in order to access the overshoots, you have to hit the options menu and check overshoot. And what this is going to do is take the value of the last frame and the next frame and jump it way past the frame that it's going to. It's going to exaggerate those curves so that it bounces back. Now we could do this for frame 6 or frame 30. But I'm going to show you for frame 30. What we're going to do is take that slider and put it in the positives. We put that to positive 120. Now our frame 19 is 20% more exaggerated than frame 30. So after frame 6, it's gonna go 20% past and then settle back down. Now it looks like this. Typically after Tween Machine, I will still do a polish pass. Just because everything looks twinned in timing, if you don't either change the value so that some things are slower, or even drag some keys around so that they're not hitting on the same frame, it's much cleaner to keep it on the same frame if you use Tween Machine on specific things to have them get to their destination sooner, or drag at the last destination longer to feign the fact that you're dragging the keys around. But typically, I will drag the keys around because it's faster. What I like to do is add a drag on the wrists, the neck, and the fingers, because that's going to make things look the most fluid. The rest is kind of the top 5% that you could spend 50% of your time on, so it's not that important, especially when you have a deadline. What I'm going to do is around frame 12, add another breakdown pose. What I'm going to do is drag the wrist back. I'm going to curl the fingers more. I'm gonna grab the neck controls. Since she's moving her neck back, I'm gonna take it forward. And then I'm going to use the overshoot to recalculate with that new pose in there. Otherwise, your curves can get a little wonky. Now things look a little less twinned in timing because we added one extra breakdown. But all of the keys are still the same. The key to making things look organic is to make not everything hit at the same time at the same speed. So that could mean taking one arm and making it slightly faster than the other arm. Usually the leading arm will be the one to be a little bit faster than the one that drags behind. If she's really angry, you could make the neck reach its destination before the rest of the torso, or if she's really depressed, then you could give the head a lot of drag, make it really slow so that it looks like she's slumped over or something along those lines. That's basically enough to get you started with Tween Machine. If you found this tutorial helpful at all, please consider giving it a like, subscribing if you want more, and leave a comment letting me know what you'd like me to cover next. Anyways guys, thanks for watching, and I'll catch you later.